experience that you're referring to. After all, living as an Indian in today's our country and the conditions there, I don't think any very great political experience is needed. Besides, I belong to a political party and I have taken part in many political movements of the party, so I know exactly what the political situation of this country is today.
What is the biggest impediment to women empowerment in this country since you've been voting?
I can't hear you.
What is the biggest impediment to women empowerment?
Well, you refuse to accept that women are equal and to be given their due rights.
I want to take Manoj's question. Just rephrase it a bit. That you have said no great political experience is needed. Can you hear me?
Your audio sahi kariye, bhai.
You have said that no great political experience is needed. What exactly is your opinion? Do you mean that a person who is going to be the president of India should have a perspective or actual experience in political life? No, I'm not talking about her. I'm talking about...
To have a perspective, it will lead to the, dealing with various problems. It's not such a, difficult...
In your statement, Captain Sehgal, you have said that federalism is a key feature of our constitution and Article 356 has been misused last year. Do you think, in the backdrop of the events like the affairs of particular in Gujarat, was there a fit case of use of Article 356?
Do you think